Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding bills that don't match promises written by Arun Kumar. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is very, very important from your essay and interview point of view. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is basically about the formalism. This editorial is about the inability of the government to bring prosperity for everybody. Now, everybody is very important here. This editorial is about creating up a regime of equitable development. This editorial is about what government should do, how should the government resurrect and correct its path of development. Now, in order to understand this editorial, in order to comprehend this editorial, we basically need to understand the concept of development, and we also need to understand how an alternative, how there is a need to create an alternative paradigm for this concept of development. Now, development as a concept, as a theoretical concept, it is not a sui generis. It is not something that has evolved from within. Development ka concept ek aisa concept hai jo hamari conditions se ubhar ke nahi aaya hua hai. This is a concept that is a borrowed concept. This is a concept that has been imposed on India. This is a concept that helps in giving favors, that helps in giving succor, that helps in giving support only to the top section of the society. Now, we also need to understand why this concept of development was incepted. Iska janam kyun hua is concept ka, development ke concept ka. So we have two kind of economic systems operating in the world, that is the capitalism and the socialism or the communism. Now, as far as this socialism and communism is concerned, they promote, they exhibit, they project the welfare for the entirety. Now, what is meant by entirety? Welfare for everybody. There is no discrimination as such in this concept of socialism and communism for the people. It treats everybody equally. It wants to confer the benefits to everybody. It wants to divide the prosperity equally. It wants to divide the welfare equally among the people, and it treats everybody equally. There is nothing called as first or second or third in this concept of socialism or communism. But as far as this capitalism is concerned, it promotes a society in which the profits are garnered, the profits are collected by the capitalist class. Now, at the face, this system of capitalism, it looks to be very to the poor people. It looks to be antithetical to the welfare of the people. At the face, ये बहुत बुरा कंसेप्ट लग रहा था कैपिटलिज्म का. नाउ इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोजेक्ट इट्स नाइसनेस, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोजेक्ट दैट इट इज अ गुड कंसेप्ट, इन ऑर्डर टू मेक इट सेल्फ एक्सेप्टेबल टू द पीपल, इट हैड कम आउट विद समथिंग कॉल्ड एज डेवलपमेंट, समथिंग कॉल्ड एज डेवलपमेंट. नाउ the parent of the development is the concept of growth. Now, what does this concept of development says? It says and it believes in the trickle-down theory. It believes that if the investment will be done in the fewer industries by the big entrepreneurs, ultimately that thing will result in generating employment, and that will go in a long way in alleviating misery. That will go a long way in conferring prosperity. This is what is theoretically said by the capitalist class about this concept of development. Ki bahut bhala karega ye, bahut zyada trickle down hoga, economy bahut grow karegi, infrastructure will be created. So development, it actually acts as a support system, and the capitalism, along with this concept of development, it has protected itself. It has got itself shielded in the envelope of this concept so that there might not be a criticism. So for about 60 to 70 years, the capitalism, the class of capitalism, it has shielded itself with this concept of development. But after 50 years, after working with the system of capitalism for 60-70 years, what the society has got, what the system has yielded, what the system has produced, what the system has got for the poor people, of what it had promised. So there is a heightened kind of corruption, there is a heightened misery, there is a welfare only for a section of the society. So this system, it don't treat everybody equally. It treats the capitalist class as first. It says that the capitalist class will engender such conditions, it will create such conditions, it will build up such a milieu that ultimately the welfare of the poor people will be done. Now, what about today's editorial? Bills that don't matter promises. Development, it had promised a lot, but what it had given to the people? Nothing much. It had promised alleviating hunger, it had promised alleviating poverty, it had promised the welfare of the farmers, it had promised the welfare of the peasants, it had promised that the government will be providing an enabling role. So the legislations, the bills that has been discussed in today's editorial, why do they sands of formalism, the sands of formalism, the sands of divergence? Something else was advertised and something else is given, something else was shown and something else is given, something else was projected and something else is handed over to us. Now this is reflected in the pending bills, goods and service tax bill. This is reflected in the land acquisition, rehabilitation and resettlement bill. This is reflected in the black money bill. This is reflected in the whistleblowers bill. This is reflected in the n number of the bills. Now what all these bills convey? The content, if you go into the nitty-gritties of these bills, if you go into the vitalities of these bills, if you go into the souls of this bill, you will get to know that ultimately these bills are for the sustenance of the crony capitalism. These bills are for the welfare of the capitalist society. These bills are for endangering the federal system of the country. These bills are against the farmer section of the society. And in order to properly understand these, why they are against the section of the society, we need to read all these bills thoroughly. That will be done in the subsequent classes in case there will be editorial on these bills. So this is all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And to avail the information on the classes that we are offering, you can visit my websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. And you can also install my application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you have liked this video, please click on the like button to share and comment on this video. And in case you have any sort of query for the civil services, you can contact me at my cell number 84594000. You can also contact me via WhatsApp. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice.